Drake here, Vblog, 10/7/2003, wow, October 7th, I guess it'll be my birthday sometime next week, so I have a little bit of fun, but I'm not going to be out of town this time, otherwise I'll let someone do a little bit of other stuff, but whatever the case is, there were some cancellations and some events, so, Saturday at California. Kind of blew this entire Saturday just watching stuff on YouTube. Try to do some computer work, but Microsoft has really changed their play. They have gone really asinine. So I have a machine that was updated. Okay. So it just needed a complete reloading. And usually when I reload it, I usually swap the hard drive out. So I have a backup copy of stuff and I just put a new drive in there and reload it. Now it had a Windows 7 Pro key. Don't get me wrong, the Pro OEM keys a lot of time can be activated on Windows 10. It's one of the reasons why they're actually needing the activation structure. I'll tell you in a second. But the current activation structure, especially with a machine that you don't use a Microsoft account, especially for Pro, because Pro, when you set it up, you can set it up for a domain and a local login, so you'll move it to the domain later. When you move it to a domain, it's secured by the domain. Not by Microsoft account. Now, don't get me wrong, this is a push to Microsoft accounts now on all new modern machines. There is not really a way around it, rather setting up a family set of computers or upgrading it to Pro and moving towards business accounts. I can understand that because every industry is doing that the same way, and it has a different level of support when you contact the industry side. You can't be cheap anymore. The guy who buys all this stuff behind me and more stuff in front of me that just appeared out of nowhere. Doesn't seem to get it in this date and time. And I hate to say it, there's a thing called transfer of wealth. I'm not saying that it's a good thing or it's a bad thing, but it is going to happen. And there are many things out there that are subscription-based that they can turn it up. For example, when you're renting from someone else, you're literally paying a subscription. So that's the share economy with a little bit of control. And then if it's an open market, you have competition and you have additional features, keeping the price low. All of these things play a factor in a thing we call the economy. But right now, the economy is on life support, as quoted by a few people. And because it's on the brink right now of going in two different directions, certain things I'm watching is kind of important to figure out which direction I want to go, even though it's still pretty random, but at least like counting, like playing a good game of blackjack and counting cards, I want to be counting the cards. So I want to have the best outcome possible. So putting that in perspective, I'm running all these other projects. I'm running the Raffy toy, which I will probably throw a coupon for Columbus Day in a day or so and drop it off for anyone who wants to get some discounts during Columbus Day as well. I think it's Monday, actually, if I recall. But either way, there's a lot of stuff going on. I also got a few things that are going on, but I'm not sure if I'm going to go to it. One of them is this Reagan Museum thing. And as much as I want to go, I didn't know it cost my friend $125. And I think what it is he meant to take his plus one with there, and she can't go. So offered it to me and says, okay, you got to pay gas now. And I'm like, no. I thought you invited me to go. I was willing to join you on it, not to drive you there. Heck, I don't like driving anywhere now, and I'm kind of trying to cut down my expenses as much as I can, because if this crash is going to happen, I better be out to pull a trigger. My biggest problem I'm fighting is the lease agreement on my storage has gone up asinine, so I'm hoping to get out of the second storage there and move it back to one. So I'm going to try to get up early tomorrow and try to make it to storage to reorganize it. And if I play my cards right, they'll squeeze everything back down except for the overstock. I should be able to bring that over to another location and break down some of the storage now. My biggest problem that I now measured out that's eating up the most amount of space are the furnishing materials. And even though I moved a lot of it in there, there's a few items that don't think I can move it anywhere else, so I'm trying to figure out how to get some room moved around and things along the line without selling too much stuff, because heavy items do not sell them. When when I had an offer a few years ago, I should have taken it, but I'm now at the point where I really like to keep the stuff. You know, it's impossible. The more things I kind of remember, because I'm like, shoot, I've seen it, and then I threw it out, or sold it, whatever. I'm like, fuck, fuck, fuck. So, the reason why the guy keeps all the stuff back here, because each one of these items you see behind me has a piece of history attached to it. I don't know what the exact details are. Some of it required research. But, you know, I have a wealth of knowledge, and I ain't wealthy, so... And this guy is pretty much the same way. He's a good friend, good property owner, offering to give me a place to stay at a well at tomorrow's price. Although probably would have been better, because tomorrow's price with inflation going up, I think the joke's on him. But because of because of dramatic things going on in my life, I just need a place of my own. And once that starts happening, I'm going to have to figure out how to turn it somewhat profitable. I know you can't do, unless I have a guest house, that would make sense to do Airbnb. Then the guest house could be separated, see. Some people have suggested just use the master bedroom as your Airbnb because the fact that the master bedroom has its own bathroom that's isolated. So, and some people have really large bathrooms. I don't know how that plays a role because the house I'm living in, my family has almost every bathroom. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bathrooms all together. So everyone can get a bathroom and you have 2 extras. So if you have a small family of 4, I don't plan to have a family, and I'll reiterate this. My family thinks I want a family. I really don't. I want a museum. I want a place that I can call home and do other stuff. I might want a family, but for a different reason. Plus one would be nice to maintain the house and someone I can trust, but not the same plus one as most people think. Same. And like looking over here, it looks like it was vacuumed a few times on and off, and it happens. They're an active office. They do get stuff done. Computer's always just always on fire, but I deal with computer issues, and I try not to spend money, but professionally, I notice the more I spend money on a computer, the more I'm actually paying someone else to take over for me. So I don't know which direction it's going to go. I'm actually trying to learn Linux and many other systems that people freak out with. But computers, embedded systems, they all work the same to me, but none of them make me a millionaire. So until that happens, I'm kind of stuck with the tools I have and trying to move forward one day at a time. You can see, I will be heading off. It's after 10, so I'm going to be doing a few more. There's one other stop, and then heading back.